Hello, everybody. We are Group 3, and my name is Seshagopal Akkapeddi. This is Thirumala Reddy Mangalipalli. This is Thirumala Rapolu, and Arun Thotla, and Shashi Kasaram. These are our group members. And we did research work on storage area network and its applications. First of all, storage area networks. Storage area networks is a high-speed dedicated storage network. It establishes a connection between It establishes the connection between the servers, network users, and storage devices. These storage devices can be hard disks, tapes, etc. And these devices are connected using all the available combinations of topologies. Due to this connection, like using the available combination of topologies, there is an advantage in SAN, that is, all the servers can be accessed. And this is not possible with other servers, so this is the main advantage of SAN. Next, the data management and data transfer is consistent and efficient in SAN. SAN has an advantage of ease of fault recovery. If there is any problem in the storage devices, they can be modified because they are connected physically, they are connected manually but not physically to the storage bases. All the data assets are shared between different servers. And the now coming to the components of SAN, the major components of SAN are interconnects, interfaces, and fabrics. All these components act as interfaces are medium for communication between all the devices in the storage area networks. So the interfaces include multiplexers, hubs, routers, extenders, gateways, switches, and directories. Now interfaces. Interfaces include SCSI, that is small computer system interface, HIPPI, high performance parallel interface. So all these are all these interfaces are different types of connection to make efficient communication between the devices in the storage area network. That is, the devices like the servers, network users, and SAN. Now coming to fabrics. Fabrics establish a connection between workstations and computers to the SAN. Fabrics include switched SI and fiber channel switch to switch-to-switch serial storage architecture. So all these are the major components involved in SAN. Now coming to working of SAN. This will be explained by Thirumala Rapolu.
Hi to all. My name is Thirumala Rapolu. Coming to the working of SAN. SAN is a storage device. It's mainly developed for shared I/O processing. It offers scalability. It's an independent network. Independent network means you can share, transfer the data to the any device to any device. Scalability means it's a sharing data to the any device. This SAN consists of four major parts. So network part, hardware part, and software part, and connectivity part. In the network part, SAN provides transfer the data among the devices in the network by using FCC standard protocol. Transferring the data through the FCC standard protocol means it's like a TCP/IP protocol. TCP/IP protocol transfer the data in through the levels. There are in the OSI model level. In OSI model level, there are five layers are there, like physical layer, data link layer, network layer, transport layer, and application layer. In this network layer, the data can be transferred by using switch. It provides a set of circuits to transfer the path through the path. And in the hardware part, to make a complete SAN, it composes all components. It's all components are like FC switch, FC enabled server, and storage system. These are used to connect server and storage devices. If the FC switch is to set up circuits to transfer the data to connect the servers and storage devices through using named server, the named server is used to transfer the data any device to any device. And next two parser will continue by threading.
Hi, good evening everybody. My part was connectivity part, and next one is physical part, and software part was divided into five services. And first one is operating system services, and second one is alias services and naming services, fabric services. And in this one, operating services gives files management and memory. And next one is fiber channel services, and this one gives about how data is communicated between servers and storage services. And next one is connectivity part. And connectivity part is divided into two types. One is physical connection, and next one is logical part configuration. In physical connection is supports both optical and copper connections, and logical part configuration provides software functions that are capable of transferring protocol communication and interfaces. Yeah, that's it.
Hi everyone. By now I think you got idea of what is storage area network. Now I deal with the applications of SAN. Every organization which needs high scalable and storage, and which needs large amount of data storage will prefer SAN. The main applications of SAN are in financial applications, online transactions, and e-commerce. In financial applications like banks, we have a lot of transactions. So SAN is used to reduce the burden on the servers. And coming to online transaction, if we want to transfer any data from one account to another account, we need some data security and data integrity, which can be done with SAN. Can be done by SAN.